Hello guys, and welcome back to a new episode of the Architects3DP MEGA series, a big size and industrial quality 3D printer that I'm designing and building step by step from scratch along this series here at Architects3DP. This project is only being possible thanks to my Patreon supporters that help me keep going month to month, and the amazing sponsors of the Architects3DP MEGA that you can see on screen. In the last episode of the build, we designed in Rhino all the necessary components that we need to build the Z-axis of the MEGA. We designed all the special pieces that attach the vertical profiles to the bed of the printer, and if you remember, at the end of the video we made the order for the laser cut parts on PCBWay.com. Well, so in today's video, we're going to work, but this time with the hardware, in the Z-axis of the MEGA. Once we finish the build of the Z-axis and its moving components, we'll be finally ready to jump to the electronics and other components that will make our printer move. Okay, so to start with the episode 15, Z-axis assembly, the first that we are going to do is to start with the existing structure that we have, as you can see right here. Now we're going to bring the structure of the heated bed that I have right here, and I'm going to put it on top of the structure. Since now I'm going to present you the main elements of this video, that are, as you can imagine, the special pieces that we ordered on PCBWay in the last episode, but made reality. Here we have the two big parts that are going to be installed at the end of the bed, and here the two smaller that are going to be installed right here in the center. As you can see, when we put the laser cut aluminum part in place, it fits just perfectly. The laser work is very precise. The next elements to be installed will go here in the center, and will be the two smaller parts. They will go here and here, and finally the last big part that will go on the other end. I'm gonna leave you with a couple cool shots of the parts. Great, so we are going to continue with the build of the rest of the elements, and for that I'm going to bring the print bed structure here at the bottom. Next, we're going to install the two profiles I mentioned in the last video, if you remember, that originally were supposed to be on top, but we are going to finally install at the bottom. So we have them right here and here. They are going to be attached to the structure using these fasteners that Synerges provided a long time ago. They are composed by the bolt and the fastener itself, and we did use them in all the fixing points of the main structure. But the key here was that the profiles were precision drilled by Synerges before delivery, so we were able to assemble the structure very easily. Here, as it is a change we made later on, the profiles will fit in place, but there is no hole to insert the Allen key and tighten the bolt. So what I'm going to do now is to mark the position of the hole we need to make with the help of a pencil. As you can see, here we have it perfectly marked. And what we need to do is to drill a hole on each of the corners to be able to mount the new profiles in place. And we'll do that in all four corners. So first, I tried drilling the hole with my handheld drill, but it resulted quite impossible, and especially in this position. So what I decided to do is to disassemble the two long profiles of the bottom of the structure to bring them to the bench drill and make the holes properly. But before doing that, I'm going to bring all the profiles here at the front, and I'm going to properly mark where all the holes will be placed. Okay guys, so unfortunately I ran out of battery when I went to my workshop to drill all the holes with the bench drill. But as you can see, here we have all the holes perfectly made, on one side and also on the other. Now what we're going to do is to put everything back together. But this time, guys, remember to insert the new profiles in place before closing the corners. Everything is in place. Now we just have to tighten all the bolts.
As you can see here, now we have everything back together and ready to continue with the build.
Alright, so before continuing, I'm gonna go a little bit back on time, and I'm gonna show you the components we're going to assemble to the new profiles we just installed.
As we saw in the design process in the last episode, to the new beams, we'll mount these huge ball bearings in the center that are going to hold the lead screws of the Z-axis, as well as the two mounting brackets that are going to hold the two 20mm thick linear rods on each of the sides. I was planning to attach everything in place with the original hardware that Synerges, sponsor of the build, provided, but I ran out of bolts and nuts. I sent them an email, and they offered to sponsor as well the rest of the components of the build, what is awesome. So just a couple days later, I got this huge box that, for my surprise, included a great Christmas detail, a box of chocolates. Huge shout out to Synerges here for sponsoring the build. Okay, so back to the metal, here we have all the hardware we ordered. As you can see, perfectly organized in independent bags. So with the new hardware we got, we'll install the ball bearings using the M8 bolts and nuts just like this. And once we have it in its correct position, we'll tighten it.
I'm gonna leave in the description of the video the list of components and its references from Synerges that we have ordered to finish this assembly, and also the mail from Synerges, so you can order the parts as well if you need.
For the mounting brackets of the linear rods, we can use the same M8 bolts and nuts since they won't fit, so we'll swap them with the M4 ones. Here we go! Now back to the parts provided by PCBWay, they will be attached to the print bed frame using the same M4 bolts, but this time with smaller nuts that fit the profile. We'll simply slide the nut in place, align the holes, insert the bolt from top, tighten it, and we'll be ready to go. As I was saying before, the laser cut work has been phenomenal, since if we take one of the linear bearings provided by Damen CNC and insert it in place, it fits just perfectly with zero tolerance. I'm actually really impressed with the work of PCBWay. These linear bearings are going to be attached with M5 Allen bolts and nylock nuts that you will find in the list of components down in the description of the video. Finally, the last components that we're going to install to the laser cut elements are going to be the copper nuts that are going to move the print bed up and down through the Z-axis threaded probe. First, we'll install the printed separator that goes right here. Next, we'll put the nut on top. And finally, we'll cover everything with the 3D printed cover, as you can see. Here we will have a symmetric build in the other side of the metal, that will sandwich the laser cut part in the middle. We'll have a look later on.
Alright, so now that we know how all these parts are going to be installed, it's time to mount everything in place.
On each of the sides, we'll need two of the mounting brackets together with the M4 bolts and nuts, two linear bearings, the laser cut part where we're going to mount the heated bed, and finally, how not, two linear rods. So first step here will be to insert the linear bearing on the linear rod. Insert it on the fastener and present it in place. We'll do that with both linear rods, so we'll be able to insert the laser cut part to check the precise location to install the brackets. So this will be the location of the first bracket, and this will be the location of the second.
Remember that you don't have to tighten them completely, since probably we'll need to move them a little bit later on.
As you can see, here we have the two profiles provisionally mounted, and the movement is just so smooth. Okay, so next we'll install the four bolts on each of the linear bearings, and we'll do that in all four corners.
Once we have all four fasteners installed and all four linear bearings in the laser cut aluminum frame, we just need to install the copper nuts in place and put everything together, guys.
So we'll pick up one of the sides, as I explained you before, and we'll present it in place to finish the sandwich symmetrically from the other side of the metal. Once assembled, we'll tighten everything together. Now I'm going to make a quick test with the threaded rod to check if it works. As you can see, it works manually, but there is a lot of noise caused by the friction of the two nuts with the threaded rod. We'll see how we fix that in the future, but the important part is that it actually moves. One of the last tests here will be to install the laser cut assembly on the print bed structure. And for that, we're going to first insert all the necessary nuts on the profiles. Next step will be to align all the nuts on its holes. Once aligned, we'll place the laser cut part on top of the structure and we'll check if the holes are perfectly aligned using an Allen key. And once we get all of them in place, we're going to insert the M4 bolts in place and tighten them. Remember that this whole assembly is going to be mounted upside down on the printer. As always, we'll do the same with the other side. Last step will be to install the central pieces. So as always, first we'll put all the nuts in place, align them with the holes, and install the bolts in place. Once we have it, we'll repeat the same process on the other side.
Alright guys, so last step will be, with a bit of help, to turn the print bed upside down and put everything together.
So we'll put the assembly right here, and we'll insert the four linear rods in place. And then we'll insert them on top of the brackets we installed before. If you remember, I told you to not tightening the brackets completely, since now we'll need to make the last adjustments, so all four will fit at the same time. After a couple minutes adjusting everything in place, we finally got it moving, guys. Now we are able to move the two extruders through the X axis, as well as the Y axis, and now also the Z axis, guys. I'm so excited to watch the printer finally working. We still need to finish the top brackets of the linear rods, as well as the installation of the threaded rods and the motors. But we're gonna do that in the next episode, since this one is getting quite long and I have no more time.
In this episode, I want to give a huge shout out to PCBWay for sponsoring this part of the project, and also to Damen CNC and Synerges for providing most of the hardware that you saw in this video. The links for the STL and step files used in this video will be, as always, linked down in the description of the video, as well as the list with the hardware we ordered from Synerges. Finally, I want to give a huge shout out to our Patreon supporters that are growing week by week for making this channel possible, and please consider joining them to support the channel as well and make Architects3DP bigger. Alright guys, so see you in the next video.